Hi guys, welcome to Mirake the Tribe. My name is Ayushi. This reading is for the sign of Libra, Sun, Moon and Rising. This is going to be for June. Now, one of my subscribers asked me to do Libra reading first because I have done May reading for Libra. I had to delay their readings. So I'm doing June reading for Libra first. Actually, they are third in number right now. But what I want to say here is that this is not going to be a 10 card Celtic cross like I always do. This is going to be about your past, present, future energy. What you should stop doing in the month of June, what you should start doing in the month of June, and what you should continue doing in the month of June. And I'll also be looking into your strength, your weakness, and what is the advice coming for you. Initially, I was going to skip the June video for this I was planning to skip the June videos, but then I decided that I'll do the June videos because I didn't want to break my flow. So I'm doing just short video. Let's see what's coming in for Libra, Sun, Moon, Rising for past, present and future energy. Okay. So I am getting two flippers here, which is Two of Pentacles and the Chariot, but I'm not taking them as the past energy because I haven't yet cut the deck, but I'm gonna see what's the message here. So for some of you, I see that you are juggling two people, or you are juggling your personal and professional life. You are trying to balance it out. While trying to balance it out, you are trying to liberate yourself. Because balancing both aspect of your life is not going to be easy. But since you are a Libra, which is you have a symbol as scale, like your symbol is scale, so that is what you keep on doing, and that is what is coming up here. And I think you're good at it, but now I guess you are just trying to be, you're trying to get comfortable doing it. Like you don't want to hustle in a way that you are always restless. I think you want to ease yourself while you are balancing things in your life, because and how you're doing it is by aligning your emotions, what your spirit is asking you to do, what your heart says, and what your mind is saying. So you're taking into consideration everything, what your mind is saying, what your heart is saying, what your higher self is asking you to do. So once you are aligning all those aspects of your life, this is your mind, which is the moon, the crescent, and this is the your physical life, which is how you react. So this is the sun here, this is your pentacle, this is your economic, this is your financial life, so how you handle your finances. And you're very determined to move forward, taking all these things into account. You want to balance everything out, because the card here, which is as the overall energy, is the Six of Pentacles. So the Six of Pentacles is telling me that you want to receive as much as you're giving, and you don't want to give you would keep an account of where you are investing your money, whom you are investing your time and energy. You are also starting something new. Some of you are starting a passionate something with a Cancer person or with a fire sign, any fire sign, Leo's. I'm also getting Scorpio, Leo, Aries and Sagittarius, Sun, Moon, Rising. And I'm also getting that this person or you are trying to stabilize your finances, and some of you are like working really hard, and you have probably a background job. Like, you are not in the limelight, you are working in the background. Okay, so we have more flippers here. Some of you will have new love coming in, or you already have someone in your life who has like triggered some feelings in you. But before that, you have Five of Pentacles and Five of Cups. For some of you, you are not feeling financially so well, and you feel that you are not feeling emotionally fulfilled because of your financial situation, or someone leaving you out in the cold. So you're crying over what has already happened. So you are crying over this person who has left you, or this is you who has left someone, and they are still not over you. But I'm getting that if you were dealing with a Libra, Aquarius or a Gemini, someone stood their ground, and also a water sign, Pisces, I'm also getting Aquarius again, Pisces, Scorpio, Cancer. So someone is looking away, like they don't want to offer their love anymore, and they are being very logical. They want to just stand their ground. It can be you. You are not getting emotional about something anymore, because I feel that someone was juggling here two people, and that's why. And you have found about like this has come to light, and you are like cutting the bullshit, and you are retreating. And for some of you, this is a karmic relationship, like from a like either from childhood, or you knew this person from a very long time, or this person is just there in your life because they had a contract with you and they have a lesson to teach you. So now let's focus on past, present and future energy for Libra Sun, Moon, Rising. Future. Okay, so Libra, this is your again present energy. So there is something definitely you are not able to make up your mind about. I think you are thinking about leaving something, dropping something. You don't want to carry this forward, and it's becoming difficult for you to keep this thing hanging. Or there is something that you are just managing, like you are barely managing to keep this thing with you in your life. I don't know if it's a person or a job, or it's something like a liability. So you wish like you could drop this, but what I'm getting here is that you can't drop it, because I don't know why. I'm getting that you can't drop it just yet. So you have to get like a lot of strength, and you need to make a strategy how you can handle it well, without compromising on other areas or aspects of your life. So you will have to drag this thing along with you, but be mindful and be smart about how you carry this load. That is what I'm getting here. And this is your present energy. Now in your past, I'm getting that something was not clear. Either you were dealing with a Cancer or a Pisces. Something was not clear in the past, and again you had two choices probably in the past, whether to be with this person or not be with this person, or between two people, or someone around you had two choices. I'm also getting that something was hidden from you for a very long time, or you were not able to make sense of what was going on. And right now, probably you just discovered that someone was juggling two people, or you just discovered that yes, I'm getting that you discovered that someone was juggling two people, because your future card is Three of Swords. So some of you definitely are dealing with a third party, and Three of Swords in future is also telling me that if you are not able to let go or drop this person, whoever this is who has been juggling two people, then you are going to prolong your heartache. Like it's your decision. If you are not able to make up your mind to let go of this person, or let go of the situation that you are in, then I think you are just going to prolong your heartache. It is going to follow you in your future. Let me see. Yes, it will require you a lot of courage to let go of this heartache. I think this is mostly sexual for some of you. This attraction is sexual, especially if it's with a Leo person. Like you are very, very physically attracted to this person that you are dealing with, but they are no good. Like they are causing you heartache, or they are not emotionally invested, or there is nothing deep in this. So it will require you a lot of strength to to carry forward this person, like to carry forward with this person. I'm also getting that even if you are trying to break away from this person, it's going to be a little bit difficult because you have the strength card, but you can do it with grace if you choose to. Someone was definitely flirting at workplace for some of you, and this person could be your wife or husband who has been doing this, like he has a family, this person has a family, still they were flirting or they were involved with different people, or they just like the attention of other people, or they just get distracted by good looking people or something like that, or they are just distracted at work. They're not focused at work. They might be telling you that they are trying to focus at work, but I don't think they are able to do it. I'm not saying that everybody here is cheating. I'm just feeling here that if someone is saying that they are very focused on their work, or they are telling you that they were busy at work, I don't think that is the case. Or there is one more possibility, that your partner is currently really struggling at work, like they have a lot of challenges at work. So that is why they are finding it a little bit difficult to manage their work life and professional life. So you will have to figure it out, like not everybody's partner is going to be a cheater. So apply it to your own situation, how it is for you, because what I'm getting here is that this person has a family, but they are not able to focus their time and energy with respect to their family life, or in their family lot of people have a lot of say, like they allow a lot of people to have a say in their family matter, which is not sitting well with you. Some of you wanted to stay single, or someone in past decided to stay single for some of you. You fought for this like you were hell-bent upon the fact to understand why someone was behaving a certain way, and you fought for this entire situation. Guys, electricity. There is no electricity here, so give me a moment. I don't know if it's gonna work, but I'm going to try. My candle is almost over here. I have to buy a new candle also. So if it works, then it works. I don't think it's working. Is it? No, it's not working. So guys, I think I'll just stop this video here, and then I'll make a new video, and then I'll post it, because this is not gonna work. So I'll see you again, and follow me. Like there would be a second part to this video that I'll post. So find that, or I'll just link it in the comment section somewhere. So just find it. See ya.